Yes.
The key
is the individual egg
and letting the message of the egg emerge into its outer beauty. So you don't know what you're going to do until you actually meet and become acquainted with your egg.
None. I came with an open mind. I haven't had strategy in about 5 years. I think these glasses are going to bring me good luck.
I've had a strategy for months since last year.
Oh.
Okay. I think.
Does it look like a plan?
No, I just came up with it a couple days ago.
Okay.
Okay. I don't know. I can't tell.
Caitlin?
I can't bring it.
Egg of the year.
Be awesome.
That's a good strategy.
My strategy in life.
I think I like pink and blue. And my heart rejoices because all my children are under one roof today.
Yes, there's a lot of people here.
Yeah.
What do you think of that?
Carol is the one to beat.
I'm sorry, what was the question?
Oh, sorry, you're a...
No.
Okay. Seems to be the general consensus. Okay.
I have a couple of ideas. We'll see if the execution...
Look, she has a couple of ideas.
We'll see if the execution can live up to the ideas.
She came strapped.
I was not blessed with a great deal of artistic talent, but I have a lot up here.
Okay, all right.
Sabotage is what I'm saying.
All right.
I don't know what in the world is going on. I know that I have ideas, but
I have no ideas, whatever. I don't have anything to share.
Do you have any strategies?
No.
None? Just winging it?
During Lent, back in the 300s, when the church created Lent as a period of 40 days of fasting, you could not eat meat or meat products, of which egg is considered to be a meat product. So before Lent starts, you eat all the eggs and you get rid of everything, but chickens don't know it's Lent, so they keep laying eggs. And so all of a sudden, by the time you get to Easter, you have all these eggs that you have nothing to do with because you weren't able to eat them during Lent. So now, on Easter Sunday, you color them, and you enjoy them, and you play with them, and then you eat them. And that's how we got Easter eggs.
Yay! Old
eggs?
Here come the dogs!
What makes a good Egg of the Year judge, in your opinion?
Good question. You have to really have an open mind and consider all of the shapes of the eggs, even though they're about the same, but the quality of the work. And then certainly making sure that you are impartial should you peek through the window during the ordeal.
Honestly, I don't know.
Okay, thank you very much.
And we have many categories and, you know, we have to fit the bill.
Right. Thank you.
Fit the bill, whatever.
Excuse me, Ed.
Hey!
What is your role as a judge? Like, what? How do you judge these eggs?
Oh, I take this very seriously. We judge them by their authenticity, by current events, by being beautiful, being relevant, and of course, not being cracked.
Gotcha.
Mark, as an Egg of the Year judge,
yes.
What's more important to you as you oversee all of the eggs on the table?
To me, it's interesting. Every year is different. The most important thing, I think, for a contestant is creativity. You never know what you're going to get when we judge these eggs, okay? We don't. It's not like the Oscars where you have certain categories every single year. I mean, sure, we have Egg of the Year, Best Supporting Egg. But outside of that, the categories, basically, I have to create based on what I see. So it's the eggs themselves that really inspire me as a judge to come up with the categories. So in a way, my job is just as creative as a participant's. And for the participants, you know, what comes up, you know, to make the best egg, I don't know. You know, it's like, I don't know how they get, where they come up with these ideas, but it's with inside the egg, you know, whatever's in the egg. I think, in a way, you know, in one way, these eggs will never actually be hatched. But in another way, with these participants, they are hatched into beautiful ideas that give life to these eggs, you know? And each one is an individual, just like we are when we're born. So if you think about it, it's kind of a beautiful thing.
Isn't there anyone who knows what Eastern this is all about?
Making him happy, as opposed to, oh, if I don't do this, he'll be mad. If I don't do this, he'll be mad. If I don't do this, he'll be mad. That's all crap, you know? We just live in his love. Everything we've done wrong, he took care of on the cross. That's what this weekend is about. This weekend is the weekend 2,000 years ago when Jesus forgave all my sins, even the ones I haven't done yet. This is the weekend that he gave me his unconditional love. This is the weekend he covered me in his grace so that I can live a life of freedom and happiness and joy. 2,000 years ago, on this weekend, when he was on the cross, he was thinking about me and seeing my face and loving me. That's incredible. And I can never live up to that. But I don't have to. He doesn't even ask me to.
Round of applause, everybody. Go, Jesus. Yeah. Okay, hold on. Hold on, hold on. Time out, time out.
Here comes Peter Cottontail, hopping down the bunny trail, hippity-hopping, Easter's on its way. Bringing every girl and boy, baskets full of Easter joy, things to make your Easter bright and gay. He's got jelly beans for Tommy, colored eggs for Sister Sue. There's an orchid for your mommy and an Easter bonnet too. Oh, here comes Peter Cottontail, hopping down the bunny trail, hippity hoppity happy Easter day. Hippity hoppity happy Easter day.
Okay.
First of all, I'd like to thank everybody for coming to the 17th annual. We just found out it's the 17th annual Egg of the Year contest. And as always, just you know, on behalf of the other judges and my own self, I just want to say you guys just keep raising the bar. Right? Give yourself a big round of applause. So now let's get on with the presentation of the awards. First one we have is, we call this one the Gamer's Egg. The Gamer's Egg of the Year.
Oh,
oh, that's me. Hey! Hey!
Yeah, yeah. Gamer's Egg of the Year. He followed up the Parched Earth.
Yeah.
The beauty of that, Mark, is one made the egg, one made the kite.
Nice.
Okay, this next one was very creative. We really enjoyed it. We call this one the sunny side up, sunny side down egg.
Night and day.
Okay, this next we call the beach and the stag of the year. Piatchiness. Economical egg of the year. Alright, this next one had several to qualify for the category, but only one prevailed, and this is the egghead of the year. The egghead of the year. Scary. This one we simply call the fruitiest egg in the year.
Oh, Michelle! Oh,
category every year because we have those among us who are very holy people. The religious egg of the year this year is Bada Bing!
He is risen. That's surprising. It looked like it was done by a six-year-old.
I'd like to thank God. Okay, thank you.
It's a little messy, but yes. Michael, thank beer.
Thank you, God, for beer.
Alright, in a sort of in a way a related category, I don't know. We call this one the Born Again Egg of the Year. The Born Again. Off right now, Rachel. Everyone, okay? Because we're right down to the thick of things, okay? Everyone's come down to this. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to present to you. And just in case the egg of the year cannot fulfill its duties, we have the best supporting egg. And here it is. Yay!
Optimum! Complete with
princess
and the babies.
I love it.
Jeremy, you know where this is going, buddy.
Amy, you did that.
All right. And now, ladies and gentlemen,
The moment you've all waited for an entire year. Come on, hurry it up. Hurry it up. There we go. The 2009 Egg of the Year. Right there.
For Egg of the Year.
Be here for the first time ever. I'm glad that I was invited by Mark Wojchick and his lovely wife. And
I'm sorry I invited the buddy along.
Sorry that I won. I wasn't really trying to. I just did this. It was cool. But you guys, I love you all.
Okay, again, everybody. Hey, what a great contest! Yeah. Everybody, give yourself one more round of applause.
Egg of the Year.
This is all about Charlie Brown.
Patty, okay, as an Egg of the Year judge, what is it that you look for in an egg?
Well, the most important thing, you have to know your participants. And then that way you kind of have an idea who did what egg.
Hey, that doesn't sound very impartial to me.
You have to be impartial.
Wait a second.
I don't know how to do that.
Do we need to start this over again? Is Michael going to win? We'll see. If so, you have very incriminating evidence.
No, because he's too drunk to do one good.
Go ahead.
Also, rumor has it, some people started, got a head start before the official proclamation of the beginning.
We won't mention any names, but their initials are pretty strong.
Okay.
Michael's on his way home from work, but he was all nonchalant.
He's probably
in Pilates. He's like,
It's the new sensation. Do the
bunny hop. Sometimes those artists are just downright cutthroat.
Yes, that's true.
True words were never spoken.
Very true.
Have you ever noticed that, Carol?
I'm sorry, Rich. I was ignoring you.
That's the best one of the year. That's the best one of the year.
Sort of passive aggressive.